another classic. Rusty Jux. Archetype on the track. What up? Straight to the top. I'm taking it, just for the record. I'm breaking it, breaking it. I did it when they said that it can't be done. To become number one, the champion. Yeah, straight to the top. Taking it, just for the record, I'm breaking it, I did it when they said that it can't be done.
What's going on, guys? It is your boy, Beer Gut Plays here, with another episode of the WWE Smackdown Shut Your Mouth Season Mode with Kane. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed the content so far. If you guys like the content and you want to see this channel grow, make sure you super kick that like button, comment down below, and subscribe to this channel for more wrestling content. Be sure to check out the other series that I am running on this channel, the WWE 2K23 My GM Mode. Now, hopefully you guys have enjoyed it so far. We are super deep in that thing, not having the best run, but I am having a lot of fun dropping the content on a daily or on a weekly basis for you. We're going to try our best to stick to the schedule that I have planned. I'll leave the link to the WWE 2K23 My GM Mode in the top right-hand corner right here. Now, guys, it's just been a hectic past couple weeks for me. I do apologize, but we are just having a lot of fun with this series, the SmackDown Shut Your Mouth. We are going to be starting the SmackDown Here Comes the Pain with Edge here very shortly for Throwback Thursday, so hopefully you guys will check that out. This is Saturday night. I can't think of a clever name. Saturday Night Retro Fest. Hopefully you guys are excited about this. I am really excited about bringing this to you. I'm recording this on Saturday the 4th. This will be dropping on Saturday the 11th now. I got a little libations in my belly as we do not have a match for this week, but I want to show you what I'm drinking. I am actually drinking the Cactus Jack, the Bang Bang West Coast Double IPA now. As you guys know, obviously, I'm a beer guy. I am a wrestling beer guy on top of that. Unfortunately, the brewery that created this, Full Tilt, is no longer in business, and I want to show them love. Give them their damn flowers. It when you combine two or three of my things, two of my favorite things, wrestling and beer, into your business model, I supported them as much as possible. Unfortunately, me trying wasn't enough. We actually do have a match. I'm sorry. I'm blitzed out of my mind. It was a four-pack. These things are 8% alcohol. And on top of that, I have been drinking the Beast, the Monster Energy drink alcoholic Monster drink, which is very good, surprising. I switched over to these things. Slowly but surely been drinking them during Crown Jewel, which was a I thought it was a good event. Everybody wants to talk about, you know, they want to talk about predictability in the product. Well, you know, WWE has a career section on their webpage. If you think you can do such a better job, why don't you fucking fill out for it? This is me drunk being a fucking asshole because, honestly, I'm just so tired of hearing about it. I enjoyed the event for what it was. come on, y'all knew LA Knight was not gonna win that motherfucker going into this thing, so whatever. Kane and Matt Hardy, normal fucking Monday Night Raw match. Kane, two moves into the match, is hitting a fucking tombstone. Oh, another move as I'm pouring myself a little more of the libations. Stomps on Matt Hardy and hits him with a big, beautiful clothesline. Don't expect this bad boy to run too long, but, you know, it's gonna be fun. Neck breaker by Kane right there. Kick. What a counter by Kane and a kick. Kane no selling this bitch. Kane. The uppercut. Uh-oh, got Matt Hardy by the throat. And what is old Matt Hardy going to do here? Chokes. Slam City. We gotta get him off the ropes. And we're gonna... Jesus Christ. And here we go. Kane no sells it, of course. The falling reverse DDT. God, I haven't seen that move in forever. Grabs Matt Hardy by the back of the head. And working over the neck of Kane. Absolutely. Working the neck here. God. Big clothesline. What's Kane gonna do? God. We are just standing on that top rope right here. Matt Hardy barely connects with that crossbody. Kane absolutely working that neck over. Misses the diving clothesline. Hits the big boot, though. They're just completely embarrassing Matt Hardy. Nips him with that clothesline. Matt Hardy with the kick. Sends Kane's in the ropes, misses the elbow. Into the gut. Suplex City, bitch. We're gonna hit the tombstone here. And that's going to be a three count. Kane is going to be victorious in this matchup. Matt Hardy with another devastating loss. What a win for Kane. Michael Cole gonna interview us. Congratulations. You know, just gotta say this. It's absolutely insane that Michael Cole has missed like 3 Monday Night Raws in the past 25 years. Fucking absolutely insane. And honestly, I'm a bit of a junkie when it comes to shit like that. And we're going to be teaming with Booker T to take on Chuck Palumbo and Matt Hardy. Holy crap. I'm here for it. I'm here. That's going to be an absolutely insane match. You boys got to keep a little bit of enthusiasm, obviously. And this was my Saturday off from my shoot job, killing bugs and shit. So, obviously, I'm going to unwind, play a little video games, relax, put the feet up in the air, and just absolutely have a blast thinking about pro wrestling as a whole, having fun watching it, and watching Scrubs on a rerun. God. So, you know, that's kind of your boy's MO for the past couple weeks, so. This double IPA is fucking balling, by the way. There's Taker! Brother Taker! Honestly, I want you guys to comment in the comments section your favorite wrestling game. Personally, I've always been a huge fan of No Mercy, SmackDown, Here Comes the Pain. This, as much as I love the 2K series, they're not very, they're fun, but they're not very, they're just not my thing. On his way to the ring. Jesus. Sorry about that, guys. You boys a little, tired. Even though it is 10:30 at, or yeah, closer to 11 at night, I have the strict rule of being in bed by 10 o'clock. Yeah, old guy beer gut. Personally, and that's probably why we have not seen as much content on this channel. Again, do apologize. Life got in the way, and I'm gonna try and make it right for you guys. It's just been really rough. Again, I mentioned that I am a bug killer, and it's been tough, especially, you know, I'm planning a vacation to wonderful Winston-Salem, North Carolina for WrestleCade 2023. This will be the second year in a row that your boy Beer Gut's gonna be going. I plan on trying to vlog as much as possible on that trip and just have a fun time. Absolutely was one of I could not put over the fine folks that run and, you know, all the inner workings of WrestleCade. I can't put over them enough. They've always gotten big stars. They've gotten the best indie talent. And honestly, it was on my bucket list to do beforehand. I did it last year. I'm doing it again, mainly because with WrestleMania being in Beer Gut's backyard, I live in Baltimore. WrestleMania gonna be in Baltimore. Obviously, it's a little bit out of my way. Well, and tickets are... Look, if you got that kind of money, more power fucking to you. I'm not spending fucking thousands of dollars on WrestleMania when I can go to WrestleCade. WrestleCade last year, which I don't, in my opinion, match of the year, it was Dax Harwood, who I met was a phenomenal human being. Dax Harwood taking on Speedball Mike Bailey, and that was my real first introduction to Speedball, and it was fucking phenomenal. I definitely recommend, if you can find a video of it somewhere, check that bitch out. I hate doing Meltzer style star reviews, but it was a fucking 5-star match. Dax working that old school style, you know, the very grounded old school style, and fucking Speedball quick on his feet, working like a cruiserweight. Just, I had a ball the whole 3 days. Now, the third day I locked myself, well, I don't want to say I locked myself in the room. I went and got food, obviously. Fat motherfucker like me. I got really anxious there, and I ain't gonna lie. There was just so much going on there, and I don't know. It was a lot of fun, but maybe I wasn't in the right headspace at the time. I ain't gonna deny that. So I just sat and ate food and caught up on NFL games, and I want to say Survivor Series was that weekend. Now, I was staying in the Marriott, and we had a lot of fun. It was connected to the Benton Convention Center. I feel like I don't need to sell fucking WrestleCade to anybody, but Jesus Christ, I had the fucking time of my life, and anyone there, you know, obviously, I if anybody's there just wants to fucking talk wrestling and sees this fucking video, obviously, I love that. I would love that. I'm gonna shut up about fucking my love of wrestling and WrestleCade. We got a pinfall here. And we got a big victory, I think. We're gonna go to a cutscene here. Chuck and Kane in the middle of the ring, staring off at each other. Fucking insane. We're gonna get to that. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Kane just fucking knocks Chain Chuck out. And I'm pretty fucking toasted at this point, so nice. Here we go. Backlash. Kane and Chuck. This is gonna be a short one. I can tell you already. The brain don't lie. Again, I feel like, I don't mean to put over this, kid, but if you've never been, and like I said, at this recording, it's going to be about 2 weeks until I'm in at WrestleCade, and I'm a nerd. I'm not even going to lie. I'm an autograph seeker. The big guest is Daniel Bryan. I was not paying fucking almost $1,000 for the eco-friendly belt. I ended up getting a Kane and Undertaker tag team title, you know, the legacy belts. I'm absolutely in love with them. I can't explain them. I've got 3 of the legacy belts, so hey, knock me all you want. I will show my collection of wrestling quote-unquote memorabilia on the other channel. Definitely be on the lookout for that. But it's big match time. Kane and Chuck, number one contendership for Universal title. Let's get it. Let's go. Let's have a killer, killer match. Kane and Chuck, you look so good to me. You look so good to me. Excuse me. With the uppercut and with a neck breaker. That really has to break Kane's or Chuck's neck. Chuck with the body slam. He said, "Bitch, I'm done with your shit." Big boot and it kills Chuck's momentum. Tombstone out of the gate. Need a gut. Another one. Need a gut. Uppercut. Just knocking him down. Suplex City, bitch. Oh my god. Chuck making a fucking comeback. Go for it, cover. Not gonna end up well for him. He's just gonna piss off Kane and knock him out. Clothesline. And a neck crank. Holy shit. Power bomb to a shoulder breaker. Oh, clothesline. Kick. Chest buster. And now we're gonna fucking... Chuck is gonna taunt these motherfuckers. Oh, got him by the throat. Goozled. Break. Close elbow. Kick to the gut. This is the closing. And a big DDT. Working the neck. Clothesline, we finally hit it. Is that gonna be enough to put away Chucky? 3 count, bitch. Kane is your new number one contender for the WWE Universal title. Now, throw the hoodie up. Hoodie Kane. Bitch. Kane is gonna win that match. Now he is gonna, his opponent coming up is gonna be taking on Rob Van Dam for both titles. So Kane is potentially could become a double champion with this. Well, guys. You see the No Frills background. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the content so far. Like I mentioned in the video, we're going to try and pump out as much of this gaming content as I can. Now, we are going to try and stick to that 2 times a week for the WWE 2K23 MyGM because that has been the biggest contributor to this channel. Not knocking... Smackdown, Here Comes the Pain. Videos not knocking the previous attempts to smack or the Smackdown, Here Comes the Pain previous attempts. The first attempt on this one. I just hope you guys are enjoying it. If you want to check out more wrestling content, we have rebranded the Beer Gut 410 channel. It's going to stay the same name. Rebranding it. It is gonna be a. It went from a sports channel. Now it is a WWE content reaction, wrestling. You know, vlogs, predictions, home office tour, whatever the fuck I feel at that point. I'll leave it posted in the top right hand corner if you want to check that out. Highly recommend it. We're going to be dropping some really cool content here in the near future. Need a sip of the beerski. Also, as you guys may have figured out at this point, very big fan of NASCAR and just motorsports in general. I feel like I could maybe fucking... put my opinion on some shit out there, so definitely, if you're a NASCAR fan, you're interested in my opinion, my gameplay on certain fucking NASCAR games, whatever the fuck it is, definitely recommend you check out Beer Gut Races. I will leave that posted in the top right-hand corner right here. Now, before I bid you farewell, I am super stoked about where this channel has gone. Now, I'm really excited about it. Hopefully you guys are super excited about the content. I'm really excited about bringing it to you. Obviously, we're going to have a little bit of break in the action. I apologize not being able to bring all all the content that I promised in the past to you. Hopefully, with actually my shoot job, that will kind of slow down. We're getting into our slower season. November, December, January, March, or January, February, and March are kind of our slower seasons. So hopefully we are able to get this content rolling, but hopefully I see y'all in the next video if you guys can for me. Hopefully y'all have a great day, a great evening, and until next time, my friends. Mwah! Love you very much, and peace.